first bit of dirt, Malala, got the Yama man on the team, Team Yamamoto. Alright, we've both got maps now, we've both got navigation, so looking after you, son.
I can't hear, I got music on.
Go!
Oh, so excited, oh my god, it was like being a pair of bloody 12-year-olds going on their first date, I tell you. The whole bloody build up to this, you know, keeping an eye on the weather and messaging each other backwards and forwards. Oh, have you got this? Have you got that? And bloody, you know, coming the big day and you sort of realise it's perfect weather and hardly any wind, blue skies. And oh, that was actually a really, really nice day for riding. Hardly got any wind, which is great. And yeah, riding on some really good gravel roads. Really nice countryside. I've never ridden through here before. So it's all new to me. Quite flat and vast, but yeah, a really good sort of contrast to what I normally do is, you know, normally ride through, which is, you know, hills and foresty kind of areas and stuff like that, you know. So yeah, it's quite enjoyable. Very minimal wildlife. We might have seen a couple of roos each, a lizard and a, you know, a small snake, and it was just, yeah, there was not much trying to cross the road, and there wasn't much in the way of there was a few bloody kangaroo carcasses, but there wasn't, you know, it wasn't crazy. So pretty well maintained roads. So basically we took the north-south motorway from St. Mary's all the way to Salisbury Highway and Port River Expressway, and then Port Wakefield Road all the way up to the turn off to Malala, and then basically once we hit Malala, we hit dirt. So that's what we're riding through here, through this pristine farmland, Stockyard Creek, Arwen, Alma, Salter Springs. Just looking at Google Maps, Halbury, Hoyleton, Stowe, Bowilla, Kybunga, and after that we basically took a right hand at Blythe, and headed our way over towards Clare. I mean, we were originally going to continue straight through Blythe and directly to the campground, but at this stage we didn't have any firewood and we sort of needed to fuel up. So Clare was like 15 k's out of Blythe. So we went over there, topped up the tanks, bought some firewood, strapped the firewood on the back of Ian's bike. Only just managed to get it on, basically. It was a big old 15 kilo sort of bag, probably about the size of a bloody, those old plastic milk crates. And if it wasn't for me and my special little stash of extra rope, we probably wouldn't have got it on without, it falling off, because, Ian only had a bloody 1 meter strap to try and tie that off. So I'm going to cut the bullshit. And I did a little faux pas on the camera. I mean, this GoPro of mine, it's a pain in the ass, and it doesn't really do what I want it to do for most of the time anyway. So I happened to hit the photo, what do they call it, the time-lapse photo sequence thing. So on one of the better stretches of road that we rode on, sort of more interesting, slightly more technical, but, you know, not really technical, but really nice looking, along this pipeline road, it was only taking all these photos. So I've basically put together this sort of clip, which has got, it's only a couple of minutes worth, but it's got all the photos in sequence. I had to do it in the GoPro Studio application on my computer and then export that out, because it wouldn't work in bloody, I don't know how to do it, one of the two anyway, in Vegas Movie Studio. So I'm going to quit bullshitting. I'm going to put this clip on. It's got some cool music, again by The Sword, which we've been listening to so far. And after that, we'll probably arrive at the campsite and you'll be able to check out what that looks like.
All good, bro?
You all good?
Yeah, man.
Beautiful country out here,
mate. Oh, it's nice, isn't it?
Oh, there was just a few other clips that I wanted to slot in before we hit the campground. And one of them here is the canola fields. Some of the angry farmers that don't like people going in there and taking selfies. not sure, mate, but there's also the Blythe pub here with the dudes in dresses. Must have been a end of year footy trip. Yeah, so this is where we try to get some ciders, but the pub was closed. It was 1 o'clock by the time we got there, and the pub didn't open until four. So, yeah, unfortunately, Ian didn't get his ciders, but I was kind enough to let him consume one of my purple cans. So that's the Cooper's XPA. But also this clip here of just coming over the range into the plains with the mountain range in the distance. I guess that's the Southern Flinders Ranges. But yeah, the Quacker went all right, in fact, fully loaded up. You know, we weren't going like cut snakes or anything, we just took it easy. I was taking that extra easy over some of the more corrugated sections, which there wasn't that many of, but on that section there, going up the hill, there was a little bit. Obviously being fully loaded and, you know, with the suspension dialed up to the max, and this bike's done nearly 44,000 Ks, so it's no spring chicken anymore. Anyway, we're just pulling in Appila Springs here now. So this is basically the entrance to the campground. You just gave a little cattle grid here, and I guess they can gate it off between November and April, because if you go onto Wikicamps, it actually says that it's closed between November and April. So I'm guessing that's because of fire dangers. So, you know, I mean, it's pretty dry out here as it is, you can tell. I mean, there's still a lot of green, but, you know, it's still quite dry as well. You know, we're talking, what, end of September. There's been a bit of late rain that's come through for the farmers, so I guess there's a bit of greenery still around, which is good for them. But this is one of the most, one of the better maintained campgrounds I've been to in a while. It's much better than Point Sturt in the Lake Alexandrina area. That Alexandrina Council really need to pull their fingers out and stick in a toilet and some bins and stuff, because this one has all that and more, so yeah. Anyway, we'll check it out now. I'll switch to the camera audio, and we'll go and explore the campsite, eh? Tally-ho! There's plenty of room up here if you wanted to set up. You see there's a couple of little fires there. What do you call it? Fire pits, I guess you could call it. And there was some dude swimming in this, in the springs or in the lake or whatever you want to call it. But they didn't hang around for long, and then we ended up having the place to ourselves. So that's the springs over there. So you got some tables there, solid concrete tables. Bench seats, just a little shelter there with a little bit of historical info about the place. We're just going to have a look down the end of this road. It basically ends up being a dead end with a little cul-de-sac at the end. But you know, you've got to explore. You never, never know if you never, never go. That's what I always say. See, that's all reed beds on the right. So, yeah, should it all be marshy and, you know, swampy and bloody wet in there. The good thing was there wasn't too many mozzies around. I'm guessing at night when it got too cold for them, they just didn't come out. Probably during the middle of summer it would be a little bit different, but, yeah, by the sounds of things, mate, you can't get in here in the middle of summer anyway. So, but, yeah, nice countryside, as you can see. I mean, I guess you could probably camp anywhere along here if you wanted to. You can see where the fences are, so I'm guessing it's all campground sort of area. And there's a little fire there. People have camped there, obviously.
Where do you want to go, bro? Obviously, if you need a shit, you're going to have to get on the bike and go have a shit. But I don't think that goes any further. It looks just like a reed bed there, so
True.
I mean, here it looks a bit sort of, I don't know, it's nicer back there. I don't think those guys are camping. There's no tents and shit, so.
But we, you know what? We picked the perfect weekend. It's the football.
Yeah, yeah.
Final. Everyone's at home. Fucking yeah. Pissed watching fucking footage.
It's probably a bit nicer down there, eh?
I think it's nicer down there. And there's a table and shit down there.
Yeah. Let's go and commandeer it, eh?
Yeah, I reckon. Right under the tree, you know?
Yeah.
So, yeah, obviously, we decided to go back down there. I was a little bit dubious about maybe the frogs being a bit loud, but no, the frogs were all good. You could hear them, but we were far enough away that they didn't cause an issue. They weren't as loud as the ones at bloody, Frank Potts Reserve down at Langhorne Creek. They were a different breed of frog, man. They were like bogan, partying bastard frogs, you know. They just wouldn't shut up all night. Looks like this road might get a little bit muddy too. You see some sort of dried mud there. And actually in the historical sort of information in that little shelter hut there, they could actually see, they showed some photos of when it floods. So the water comes right up to where those cars are basically. But you know, all these bins here, they've all got bloody bin liners in them. You know, it's really well looked after. The toilet was really good, really clean, didn't smell. It's like one of those eco toilets, composting toilets. It had bloody hand soap in there and paper towels and a bin and running water with a sink and all that sort of stuff. It was obviously a tank with water in it, so they must come and fill it up or, you know, rely on the rain. But
oh, actually, a bit of a lean on it.
Yeah, that was the other thing too with this bike. Because it's got such a long bloody side stand and that extra weight on it, it brought the suspension down quite a bit, so I had to be careful where I would put the thing on a side stand, otherwise it mightn't bloody stand up. So yeah, I ended up setting my tent up just here, right near this shelter, and Ian's was over there sort of where his bike is basically. But what I'm going to put on now, mate, is some footage I took on the phone. And some late night shenanigans. Well, it wasn't even late night. It was plenty early night, but it was dark. So some nighttime campfire shenanigans and cooking shenanigans. So this is where you get to hear what kind of dickheads we really are.
Here we go, bruv.
You made it. Cool.
Down here at Appila Springs of all the flies, the gentle buzzing of nature, I call it. Got to learn to love it. But there was someone swimming in here earlier. But check that out. I don't know, man. It looks a bit stagnant. There's a lot of this kind of, what do you call it? It's like fucking cow shit, but it's, you know, obviously it ain't. But yeah, have a look. You know, it's all through here. That's what all that in the water is. It's all like, yeah. Anyway, yeah, the serenity's good. No one else here. And just me and Ian had some tunes going. Tried to see how far the Bluetooth would reach. Might make it down here, so I'll just switch it off, otherwise it just gets annoying cutting in and out. But yeah, it's bloody nice here. Got nature's steps here, look at that. Little steps and stuff. Bloody beautiful. No snakes around here. No. So there's like, I don't know, what would you call it? It's like a bloody, you know, some steps going down. It actually looks pretty clear just here. You can see that. It looks pretty bloody clear. All that shit's gathered over there. So, yeah, it's pretty nice. Some animal feces. Yeah. Actually, you know what? And look at that, there's no graffiti. How good's that? We don't need that. I mean, there's a bit of scratch stuff. Some people scratch some stuff in the face of it, actually. That's not too bad. Like, that's all right. But, yeah, you don't need paint and shit. There's lots of scratchings, actually, when you look at it bloody carefully. 1977. Wow. Going back in time, mate. Nearly when I was born. Yeah, bloody beautiful. I just head back. Sun's out. You can go up there if you want. Check that out. Yeah, it's pretty cool. Some Aboriginal paintings in here, bruv. From 1977. Yeah, there's like all these engravings into the rock face.
Fucking graffiti.
Yeah.
you look carefully, you'll start to see it. I'm just going like, you know, it's really good because there's no bloody, what do you call it? Fucking spray paint shit, you know, it's just scratched in there. Looks, what's even here? Look, Lynn.
Oh, yeah.
Where you fucking go, eh? Better put Quacker Man was here then, eh?
Can I swim in that shit?
No, go over there. Where that little landing sort of thing is. Look at that, nature's steps. How beautiful is that? Yeah, it's pretty sludgy, isn't it? Look at that. It looks like fucking cow shit.
Yeah,
that
wouldn't catch me fucking swimming.
But yeah. Well, I haven't been down to touch it though. I don't know how warm it is. Yeah, so you go up here and it's like, it's a crevice.
Go out there away from the blue-green algae, you'd be right.
1976, 77, 1987.
There's a cave over there.
Is there?
Yep.
Yeah, right.
Can't get to it from here though. Oh. Gotta go around the other side. Or you swim.
Yeah, you know. So there you go, mate. Fucking get into Appila Springs on a grand final evening and fucking no cunt here and you can just do what you want.
Any frogs?
No. Nah, but they might come out later, the bastards.
Wait, here's one.
Oh, oh. Here we have Boris, expert in the KV extraction. What are we having here looking?
I'm looking at where kangaroo do poo-poo and sleep at same time. In there.
Ah, they make the song.
That's the one, Skippy.
Yep.
Son of a bitch, sleeping in his own feces.
They make a house here.
Oh, yeah.
So how long have you been an expert in cave fucking?
About 2 minutes.
2 minutes? What is a pond expert? What is what we're looking here?
Well, we're trying to find the Loch Ness puddle monster.
The padlock monster.
But we have failed again.
Look at the bog house up there. So.
Finally, we have made the decision to go to Big Cock Rock Monster Mountain.
Yeah, Monster Mountain over here. We are to be there soon. We will catch you then. We're going through the crevice of the rock. We are like rock climbing.
Oh, wait for me.
We are like the goat. Yeah, it's a bit steeping. Going down will be fun. There's the bird. It's that way there. It's pretty steep. And this way here with the fence. Let's get over here. Through here. Action, man.
Yes. We're getting close to the...
Sorry, farmer.
Yes.
Please forgive me.
Oh,
goat track.
Yes. You want taking
steps. Like the shepherd fucking.
You fucking turn into Jesus fucking.
I am shepherd.
You turn into
I am herding. Oh, one for you. Here, look.
Fucking.
I am herding. We are herding.
We are herding.
I feel like Moses going up the Ten Commandments.
That's what it's fucking like, isn't it? Have a look at it. This is how fucking. This is how some of Bin Laden used to get around, eh?
Yeah, apparently.
Okay, so here.
Looks like war, but it's not war. Yes, almost there now. Okay,
let's see.
Very good.
Wow.
Oh, kangaroo, jump away.
Very interesting rock you have.
Look, there is the best spot. Right there, quick before the ice, jumping away. There's another one looking right at us.
Hello, once again, we bring you a very good big panoramic view. Look.
Yes.
Look at this.
We made it to
it's
the
beautiful.
Top.
It's long way down rock. See the rock here everywhere?
You big don't fall rock. Here.
Long way up.
You turn into mincemeat.
It's very serious. No joking. I don't want to hear any laughing. Shh, silence. Don't be smiling or laughing at this. It's not a joke.
Move the light from the sheath of the Lord.
Oh. Freedom.
Strike me down.
Freedom. Thank you. Hello, what's for dinner? We are making some dinner tonight for you, especially on YouTube and on the internet. I would like you to introduce Mr. Juicy.
Hello!
Mr. Juicy Snag.
We do donkey penis sausage once more.
Donkey penis? Please explain the custom.
We used to do camel penis, but we ate all of them, so now we do donkey.
So almost. The camel's still around, but no penis. You ate the penis.
No penis left.
Just camel penisless. Penisless camel. You say you have this now.
Yeah, now we cook special donkey.
We must care for environment, not eat all the penis.
Hey, girl, you're right.
Bitch is all pissed off your fucking head. Been watching the grand final, fucking rooting for your tail.
Who won?
On,
I
team,
don't give a fuck, really.
Fuck the footy.
I don't even know who played.
I only just found out during the week who it was.
Richmond and W.
The Giants.
Yes.
Yeah, the fucking giant.
Cock. Go Richmond.
So yeah, fuck knows who won.
I used to follow football a fair bit.
Well, I did too back in the days.
But
what a pair.
Yeah, but that's lost interest.
It got a bit like music for me. You know, just got bored of it. Sitting there for 2 hours on a fucking
watch a footy show and
nice
bullshit.
Day outside.
Yeah,
but I didn't have a motorbike at the time. As soon as I got a motorbike, I thought, fuck that. I'm outside. I'm fucking. I'm gone.
Yeah, you're out of there. Much better than silly football shows.
I sleep like baby tonight, sucking on thumb.
Hey, listen.
Oh, that sounded wet too.
That texture.
That sounded wet. Oh, just fuck off. You see what I have to fucking deal with here? He's dropping his guts. It's a nice fire though, isn't it?
I think it's incredible.
Whee!
I've got to say my new BMW, the new BMW KLR 650, it's going really good. Hasn't missed a beat. I've got...
Please, can you be quiet a little bit? I feel like I am in the city here.
Wake up my Yamaha horsey.
We are stopping here in Paris BP in Snowtown. And they are having butter chickens, Indian food inside. Beautiful. Complete. Look. Butter chicken, mango lassi. Fucking beautiful.
So if you're stopping at Snowtown BP, you can get yourself some curries. Yeah. In the background of the what is that called, the Red Hill bloody wind farm. They go on for miles, bloody miles, I tell you. And then you've got a little rest stop here, pull up camp for the night. Nah, not quite, but if you need to do a wee, apparently there's a lineup, so you're better off just pissing against the electric fence, because it feels good, doesn't it? That tingling sensation.
Voltage.
High voltage cock and ball. Look at that. Wind farms galore. And they're only just turning. It's not really windy at all today. It's pretty good on the road, gotta say. It's fantabulous. Hang on, look. Camels have been here again. Left their mark. So yeah, Perry's BP, get yourself some curries and fuel up good. Nice for camping here. Can be camping. They got frisbee. Look. Oh. Let's play frisbee.
Oh, it's boomerang, no? Oh.
Anyway, this is very good. Lochiel. Lake Lochiel.
Any fishies?
Oh, look, if you want to get some salt for the shaker, you can get it fresh here. Pig salt. Oh, don't get too squishy.
This is where anchovy lived then.
Oh, getting squishy. My boot getting squishy.
Oh.
Yeah. Wow, look at the salt. It's fresh salt. Look at that. Touch it. touch it, it's fresh.
Yes.
Wow, look at that.
And yet radioactive.
Taste it. Salty.
Salty.
Wow.
Good.
Fresh salt. Some idiot come here in the four-wheel drive and make it a bog mark, look.
Yeah.
I don't think we bring the bike here because a little bit too...
The land speed record was broken here a long time ago.
Oh, salty. I can smell my armpit. It smells like barbecue onion.
So yeah, that was Loch Eel. Loch Eel is a salt lake, I guess you'd call it. And there's actually a camping spot a little bit further up here. But it's on the right. It's not really that that great to look at. I reckon that little spot we just found there would have been better. But you're probably not really allowed to camp there. But shitloads of bloody tourists up here. There was juicy vans and bloody, you know, lots of Japanese tourists and minivans and stuff like that, but they're all on the beach there on the lake. You'd see them in the distance. I was wondering what the hell they were doing, but just in there on the right, mate, that's apparently a little camp spot there, and there's some car parks there. You can see all the tourists, bloody tourists, I don't know. But yeah, mate, we'll leave it there. There's enough of shenanigans there to last a lifetime, I reckon, and you know what real dickheads we are. But anyway, mate, it was a great weekend, good night's sleep, and hope to do it again sometime. So if you've made it this far, mate, thanks for watching and sticking around, and you know how it goes, keep on quacking. Over and out.